You may be an electrician or an electrical engineer. This video is going to be crucial for you all, because through this video, I am going to explain you about the interlocking. Let us first discuss what is interlocking. After that, I will explain you the whole concept of this video. Friends, as you can see, I have two lamps here. And to turn on and off these lamps, I am using two contactors here. These two contactors I have, I mean these load here. Among these two loads, one load at a time need to be on. I mean if I turn on one load, other load must be turned on, or if second one is turned on, then first load must be turned off. If this kind of condition is asked in your circuit that at a time only one load should remain on, then this is known as interlocking. Now you have to understand that in how many ways we can do the interlocking of these contactors. Friends, if you go for interlocking of contactors, then there are numerous ways to do it. This depends on how you perform the wiring of circuit. Mostly three types of interlocking is used. First interlock is mechanical interlocking. I already made a video on mechanical interlocking. I will provide the link in description. After this, second interlocking is electrical interlocking. I already made a video on electrical interlocking also, so you can find the link of this video also in description. Now there is third type of interlocking. Third type of interlocking is push button interlocking. This means I will do the interlocking of these push buttons in such a way that when I turn on one push button and when another push button is turned on, then this first contactor which turned on through this push button will automatically turn off. So I hope you got the whole concept. Let's move on to wiring part. So here I have two contactors. To operate these contactors, we have to provide phase supply and neutral supply. For connecting neutral supply, you have to directly connect the supply and provide neutral supply to both the contactors. At the output terminal of this MCB, I am connecting one wire. I will get neutral power supply in this wire, so take this wire and to this contactor at A2 terminal, connect this wire with this terminal. Now at this A2 terminal, connect one more wire and take other end of the wire to this second contactor. We will provide neutral power supply to this contactor also. Now to both these contactors, we have to provide phase supply also. For this, what we will do is, the MCB we have, at the output terminal of this MCB, where you will get phase supply, connect two wires together at that point. Now this yellow wire we have, take this wire and to this stop push button, connect this wire in this way. After this, take the second wire and to the second stop push button, provide input power supply. After this, the wiring which is going to be performed, in this you can see power supply going from stop push button is connected to input terminal of start push button. You can also see here, at the back of start push button, two contacts are connected. This means the push button you have at the back side of this button, the element which you are going to connect, among that one element must be NO contact and another must be NC contact. The NO contact which is present here will be used to turn on the contactor, and NC contact here will be used to interlock the contactor. How it is going to be done, you will understand later. For now, in this stop push button at output terminal, connect one wire. Take other end of the wire to the start push button. In this push button, if you look at the back side, the NO contact here, we will provide input power supply to this NO contact in this way. Now if you look at the circuit diagram, you will find that the start push button you have, the power supply going from here is connected with another start push button at NC contact. This means to turn on the other contactor, the start push button you are going to use, in this push button, you have to use one NO contact and one NC contact. So what we have to do here, the start push button we have, the NO contact of this push button here, at the output terminal here, connect one wire. Take other end of the wire and to another start push button at NC contact here, with this NC contact, you have to connect this wire. After this, this second push button here, the NC contact which is connected to this push button, from output terminal of this NC contact, connect one wire. And to the first contactor here, to turn on this contactor, at A1 terminal, you have to connect this phase supply. For this, with the NC element of this push button, connect one wire here. Now take other end of the wire and the contactor you have. In this contactor, if you look here, you will find A1 terminal. Here A1 is written, so with this terminal, we have to connect this wire. So I am simply connecting the wire here in this way. After this, the stop push button you have, the power supply from here will go to first start push button at NC element. From here, power supply will go to second start push button at NO contact. After this, power supply from here will directly go towards contactor to turn on the contactor. So at the output of this stop push button, I am connecting one wire in this way. Take other end of this wire and to this first start push button, the NC element present in this button, you can see here is the NC element. So with this, you have to connect the wire. Now in this start push button at output terminal, I am connecting one wire. Take this wire and this second start push button we have to the NO contact of this push button, you can see here is the symbol of NO contact. So with this contact, you have to connect the wire. Now in the NO contact in this start push button with the output terminal here, connect one wire. Take other end of the wire and in this contactor, the A1 terminal here, with this terminal, you have to connect this wire. After this, the wiring which is going to be done, in that what you have to do, the start push buttons you have, in both these push buttons, with the parallel to NO contact here, the contactors you have, this NO contact will be used for holding of contactor. So this start push button here is used to turn on this contactor. What we will do, at the input terminal of this start push button, I mean at input terminal of NO contact, connect one wire. Take other end of this wire and the contactor you have with the NO contact of this contactor, connect this wire with that contact. Now in this same push button at NO contact with the output terminal of NO contact, connect one wire like this. In this way you have to do the connections. Take other end of this wire and the contactor you have with the NO contact of this contactor, output one, with this contact, connect this wire. Look, first we connected this wire from the input terminal of this push button. And then from the output terminal of contactor, we connected a wire with the same push button at output terminal. This means, in parallel to NO contact of this push button, we connected NO contact of this contactor. Now, same as like this contactor, we have to make holding circuit for this contactor also. For this, what we will do, with the NO contact of this push button, connect one wire with this contact. Take other end of this wire and with the NO contact of this contactor, connect this wire in this way. Similarly, the output terminal of NO contact with this terminal, connect one wire. Now take other end of this wire and to the contactor at A1 terminal of this contactor, with this terminal, connect this wire. I connected this wire with A1 terminal. This means with the NO contact of push button here at output terminal of this NO contact, the wire is connected because with this terminal only one wire is connected with A1 terminal. So power supply from here can come to this point. We can consider that from this point a wire is connected with this terminal for making holding circuit. So with these two push buttons for interlocking these contactors, the wiring which was required, this wiring part is now completed. Now with both these contactors, I am connecting one lamp and I am providing input power supply to this MCB. After this, we will understand the working. The drawing we have here, if you look into this drawing, you can see with the start push button here, you have to connect two elements, one NO element and one NC element. Now what will happen here is the NO element will be used to turn on the contactor, but with the same push button, another element which is connected here, which will be used to turn off the other contactor. This means for interlocking, it is used. So what will happen is, when we press start push button, the power supply will flow from here and through NC contact of another push button, it will directly turn on the contactor. Now suppose this contactor is on. After this, you will press this push button. I mean to turn on this contactor, if you press this, then in this condition, with this push button, the NC contact which is connected with this will open. When this is open, circuit get break, and due to this reason, this contactor will turn off. This means interlocking will work here. So look practically here, I am turning on the MCB. After turning on the MCB, this contactor here, for turning on this contactor, this push button is used. I am pressing this. When I press this button, contactor turned on. You can see lamp is glowing here. If I want to turn this off, I can turn off by pressing this button. After this, if I want to turn on this one, by pressing start push button, it turned on. For turning off, press this stop push button. This means it is turning on and off easily. Now we will check the interlocking of both contactors. So first press this push button and turn on this contactor. Now if I press this push button, you will see this contactor will be turned on, but this one will turn off. Like you just saw, this one is on and this one goes off. This means interlocking is working here. Now again I am pressing this push button. This one will go off and this one turns on. So you just saw, this one turns off and this one turns on. So overall, interlocking is perfectly working here. Friends, I hope you like this video. If you like this video, give like on my video. If you are new to the channel, subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching this video.